Hey, yo, King of the Dot, put your money where your mouth is. Halifax, make some motherfucking noise, yo. I am your host, Organic. You can follow us on Twitter at King of the Dot, at Organic Hip Hop. I'm gonna let the rappers introduce themselves. So to my right, Sean Young.
Pat State. Nova Scotia. Everybody go nuts, man.
Yeah. Pat State, significant other. Woo! Yeah. We'll leave it at that. We'll leave it at that.
And all the way
from the UK.
Thank you. All the way from the UK. Introduce yourselves, boys.
Yo, shout out Murdoch Mysteries. It's Shuffle T and Marlo.
Yo. Make some noise.
No. You know what? Make some noise for them.
Again.
Come on. Let's go. Leo.
So y'all are actors, right?
Yeah, there you go.
Magic Mike? Tight. I watched that shit twice. Last night. Fight Club? Nice one. I was wondering where I recognize you guys from. Boy, what you know about a motherfucking polite thug? Tight hugs, gang signs, I'm nice, cuz. I love you, motherfucker.
Yeah, he loves you, motherfucker. And that's how you say that shit in sign, cuz.
You such a stand-up dude, you don't even lie, cuz.
You've been a stand-up dude so long, you probably need your thighs rubbed.
I will make you keep your eyes closed, cover your head with a blindfold, and lead you in the room with all of your friends on your birthday like surprise,
cuz. I don't know if y'all are better rappers or method actors. To show off your fucking memory, you said your verses, and then you said them backwards.
You could play Michael Clark Duncan and William Shatner in the same scene, and no one'd be able to tell the difference after.
Tell them about how fucking forgiving
this
they are.
This motherfucker is so forgiving.
Yeah.
He caught me getting brains back at his girl's place. Stole this watch he had since the third grade he got from his dead dad on his birthday. Yeah. Found his pet parakeet decapitated with its head in the back of the birdcage, and he said he couldn't forgive me because he wasn't mad in the first place.
Fucking Shuffle T is kind.
Fucking sweetheart.
You ever talk to the kid? You got a bad situation? Well, he's got a positive spin. And have you seen his golf swing? The way he locks in his wrist? Kid loves musicals. Knows every word to Oliver Twist. And look at fucking Marlo. My God, is he trim. His body looks like he got fucking locked in a gym. I mean, your chemistry, it's like you're fucking probably twins. So I just hope to compliment you as well as you compliment him.
Marlo is kind. He saw my Facebook post about my missing wallet. An hour later, he returns it with an extra $50. Then later I find mine in a different pocket. Opened the one he gave me and saw his ID with his picture on it.
And a couple condoms. We thought those would come in handy.
Yeah, right.
We tried them on.
Way too fucking baggy.
Bro, your dick has a pulse. It grows like the Hulk.
Players.
You buy Plan B pills in bulk. You're so sarcastic and witty. Bet you fucked half of the city.
Get off the plane, all the girls just started flashing their titties.
They sensed your animal instincts and your passion distinctly. Fucking, you're so comfortable with himself. The way you were dancing to Britney. They fucking saw your manners. It's like you're fucking back from the 50s and how your dick would still get hard after a gallon of whiskey.
Woo! Hey, all jokes aside, real talk. Soon as we landed, we went to a bar for a couple drinks, that's it. You went to the bathroom, and a stranger showed you his big fat dick. True story.
It's true.
So just when you think it's a joke and we just spit that shit, now you know, motherfucker,
we really live that shit.
Gay pride.
Let's go. It's a fucking noise, man.
Chip.
Look how serious
he is. Round one, it's on Marlo and Shuffle T. Let's go.
Did you like that?
Fucking loved it.
Loved doing it.
Hold it down, yo.
You are a man. You will always be a man. Every woman on earth will always look at you as a man. Humongous, godlike winner. I have so much respect for dudes your size. You know what rhymes with dudes your size? You have the cutest eyes. You know what that means? You are mine. Hey, what's up, Halifax? Hey. We're Shuffle T and Marlo, and we're about to bless this stage again.
Because we repeatedly traveled back in time to this exact moment to try and get as great as them.
We know everything they're about to say.
Every step they take and when.
So you'd think by now we'd have found a way.
This is the 28th attempt.
Now I'm scrawny, balding, ears damaged due to the tinnitus, but these two magical dudes got me feeling happy with who I am. They're truly my stimulus. With Pat's lyrical ability, it's like the man's a student of literatures. And if I had just half the confidence Roan has, I'd be Bradley Cooper in Limitless. Man, from your perfect oval face to your shoulder blades, the whole display is disarming. Roni Bay the Prince? More like Roni Bay the Prince Charming.
This guy gets confused for being a poser. Not his fault he gives every human being a boner. He's got those Orlando Bloom attributes. I can't keep my composure. You've got those looks through beauty sleep. You must have been in a coma.
You're the most attractive man in the universe. It's literally true.
Camping test. Men pitch a tent when he walks into the room.
Ray Charles said you're beautiful. Helen Keller thinks that you're cute.
And Stevie Wonder wants to fuck the living shit out of you.
Pat, it's so unbelievably strong, it's obscene. Back home, my washing machine's got a problem, it leaks. They delivered me a new one, but I'm obviously shockingly weak. Plus, they dropped it off at my three-story apartment in the bottom for me. So I need a big, strong man built like an ox or a Greek. God on the scene to carry up three flights of stairs at the top of my street. And I think you're the fucking man for the job if you're free, so holler at me. You fucking...
smooth talker.
Moonwalker.
Your comedy time is the best. That's why I wasn't perturbed when my girl had gone for the night in your bed. I was happy as fuck that you fucked her. Soon as you got her inside of her legs and now won't ever, ever, ever let her wash her vagina again. Pat sees a damaged orphanage. He has to make a new one. He masturbates and you come.
And Roan's been self-confident.
What?
Smooth talking, slick little sailor from the jump. He could sell water to a whale just for fun. Making broker calls with Jordan Belfort and nailing every one. He convinced Eminem that Haley was his son. High paid, seven-figure payments in your funds. Well, I got four words for that, you little hunk. Salesman of the month!
Pat, what I'm about to say is overdue. You're physically amazing. Even your toes are huge. Are those your shoes? God only grants that kind of height to a chosen few. You're the size of a house. Maybe that's why I feel so at home with you.
We're not done.
Talk to him.
And Roan is cute. Especially when he's hugging his daughter. That's right, he's a decent guy, not just a performer. He's got that dad swag, but not that bad. I'm up in his corner because he carries it off well, like a bucket of water.
And last year...
yeah.
Last year, your compliments battle destroyed us.
We were gone in a second.
We're not even in the same bracket.
You don't belong in the sentence.
It's like finding a horror or western in the comedy section, but when you said that our battle inspired yours...
golden erection.
We're so honoured that you went and put us on in a session
just to show our fucking gratitude.
We got you a present! Man! Man! Hey. Soft. Last year, Did you guys even realize what they'd achieved together? Man, what is it, 800K?
Surely 900K.
Isn't it 1 million views given to our favorite people ever?
When they stepped on stage and swept away and gave to Sweet Surrender.
Pat in the backwards cab with the zany green propeller.
Roan handing over to Pat one of Macy's neatest sweaters in a shade of deep magenta.
These are the greatest people ever!
Get in a fight with Pat, he'll box heads like that famous scene in Seven.
Roan, your opponents always get pissed on like they were made to sleep with Bender.
And Pat fucking invented swag, there ain't no predecessor.
We got a strange love for the roles they play in this game like Peter Sellers.
No, Pat, I will not have sex with you.
Said no lady breathing ever.
Guys, the compliments game has not been the same since you scraped the green together and paid to fly out one of your neighboring nation's secret treasures.
Make noise for Pat staying in his major streams of cheddar. Duh. Dark Knight press tour. If only they could see the ledger.
Your compliments battle was
amazing,
genius,
clever,
crazy,
decent,
pleasant.
They were
sweet,
splendor.
Now that
they will be remembered.
They look
more. Hey,
great.
Hey,
they looked. Yo. They looked at how our clash with Left and Jay could be developed.
Clay to be molded like Swayze and Ghost, it was made to be embedded.
These beautiful humans saw room for improvement like when Drake released the record.
And turned up the fucking sexy in a way that we could never.
It's Lethal Weapon.
Evil Dead.
There's no debate.
The sequel's better.
In that battle, there were no losers. So now we're getting out of pen.
Visual bad bar. You both won. That's why you score 11 out of 10.
Time!
Time!
It's time. Incredible. Holy fuck.
Round two, it's on Pat and Roan. Let's get it.
Can you hear me still?
Hi, how are you?
Better now.
In my presence. Fine afternoon. Bet you taste great. You drink pineapple juice?
Flirtatious. Every time we bat an eyelash at you, you smell like lilacs. You look like the fucking Highlander, too.
Handsome, cute, pretty, yet somehow manly, too. Channing who? You give my grandmother panty soup.
My grandma, too! My dead grandma used to masturbate to you. I know I said a lot of shit in the past, but my grandma's favorite's you!
And his aunt and his uncle. And his daughter just loves you. Went to his father's for supper. He's like, how's Marlo and Shuffle?
The way my mom talks about him, you fucking thought they were a couple. My little cousin fucking kicked in the door, said how bad she wanted to fuck you.
And I don't blame her. I mean, God, you're just such a humble guy. You could fuck any girl here countrywide 100 times.
But have you seen his girlfriend?
Yeah.
She's fucking fine.
But he doesn't even care about that. He just loves her for what's
inside.
And that's beautiful in itself. God, you've got the cutest ears. Fucking adorable. I don't even know how you can hear.
You were here for half an hour and grew a beard, but I've been working on this scraggly little mange of pubes for years. I would scalp a Native American for hair like yours. Yeah, I mean it. Just let it flow in the wind. What do you need hair ties for? It's just so luscious and fluid. How the fuck do you do it? Just flaps in the wind like a flag. I fucking want to salute it.
Hey, picture this. Front porch. Old school R&B while we hang on the stairs. Me sitting right behind you in a wife beater braiding your hair. But I wouldn't want to tangle it. So smooth, they just run your fingers through it. It's like it ain't even there. It would look like a fucking soft serve ice cream on the hottest day of the year.
It's delicious. Remember when you guys had us over for those sleepovers?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you do. Sleepovers at your house are never a letdown. Their pillow game is insane. Let's just say that he gets down. It's kind of good, kind of bad.
Gets down.
We just fucking push all the mattresses together, call that shit Bedtown, and then just fucking eat a bunch of ice cream until we all gain like 10 pounds, and then light up a couple spliffs and fucking listen to fucking Pet Sounds, and the only thing higher than me is your sheets fucking thread count.
It's fucking true. I was there too. And when I dozed off to sleep, woke up at 3 to him gently putting the blankets over my feet. No one's as sweet. Brought me a snack, said bon appetit. And started making ocean sounds in my ear and said, shh, go back to sleep. Hey!
It's real! That's real!
Hey! And what else do we do, huh? When it comes to Twister, nobody could step to you. human pretzel. You just fold up like a vegetable, so flexible, left foot blue. Boom, his body bends in two. Head and shoes symmetrical, nowhere left to move. I'm damn near having sex with you, and I'm not moving anywhere. It's going down, word dog.
Dog, yeah.
You about to lose. You going down, word dog. Now, y'all didn't hear me. That's my boy. We're down, word dogs. No. Now, y'all didn't hear me. He's my yoga partner. That's my
down, word dog. Here! Here!
Take it back, you son of a bitch.
is that
sweetie pie?
Beautiful baby boys. Go ahead.
All right.
Round two, it's on Marlo and Shuffle.
Gay pride.
Listen carefully. You blow and suck, bitches. Bad. Wrong, is it? Don't you?
Other way round.
I'll reverse that sentence, man. You don't. It is wrong. Bad bitches suck and blow you.
It's the same backwards.
We want to show you our deepest gratitude, Pat.
He got us first class tickets.
He didn't have to do that.
They gave us extra leg room.
We could relax and move back.
More freedom on the plane.
Than the cabin crew had. Then the plane went into a nosedive.
They gave out parachute packs.
Only enough for women and children.
But the captain swooped back like...
You two know Pat's day?
And added to that...
Here's that four-year-old's landing gear.
You lads can use that.
Then Ron and Pat met us at the airport like...
Hi, you guys. Hope your flight was all right. And I hope that you're ready to have the time of your life.
Needless to say, spirits were high in the sky.
Our eyes were bright with delight.
We went flying our kites.
Riding our bikes.
Ron showed us what mountain climbing was like.
It was the dopest day.
Going great.
Till we bumped into some thugs with a violent side.
As you can imagine... We would die in a fight.
So as soon as we smelled conflict, we tried and we tried.
We'd hoped that Pat would step in just in time to collide with these giants in size.
But Roan put one hand on Pat's chest and denied him the fight.
He walked up to the thugs, all nine of the guys.
Whispered something in their ears, almost silent as night.
All of them simultaneously dropped their pipes and their knives, frightened and white, and all he said was,
Roni Bay the Prince.
Five of them died.
And it's no wonder. It's no wonder. Hey. Against goods, you said, they'll tune into Good Morning America to see America Morning Goods. That was such a fucking killer bar, an exceptionally awesome look. When I heard that bar the first time, I pitched a tent with my morning wood, screaming Don to fucking Marco, pounding my desk till the floorboard shook.
And Roan, if you asked me to, I'd fly from Heathrow to babysit. Because I respect what you do so much, I fucking breathe and I savor it. Our style and his style, you can see the relationship, but you're not the reason we got into battling. You're the reason we stayed with it.
And yo, when it comes to genetics, they have the perfect type of strain. Mm. So sexy, they could be cast in the works of Michael Bay. I'm difficult to compliment, but I bet they get the words and find a way. Everything they do impresses me. That's the reverse Shania Twain.
And Pat posted up something on Facebook in the days trailing up to this. Said if you couldn't afford the ticket today, then take it up with him, because he'll cover the cost it takes to pay for coming in. Suppose that's not the nicest thing I've ever heard. Oh wait, it fucking is!
Man, when Pat started sending those messages to me, I started trembling with glee. Peed my pants, my knees and hands were definitely weak. At one point he accidentally called me Shuffle. I'm Marlo, so I corrected him at speed, but to be honest, since that moment, I haven't been getting any sleep. You should never presume to be correcting a true legend when they speak, so Patrick, I'm sorry. And Adam, I'm sorry.
What?
You're Marlo now. Represent the team, because I ain't questioning a G. If Pat stays, says I'm Shuffle T, then I'm Shuffle T!
Hey! And I'm... Mackerel!
Oh, you're lucky it's a fish. I was going to drop someone.
Someone got him a
give
fucking
him a mackerel!
A mackerel.
You want to give him a mackerel?
Give him a mackerel!
Give him a mackerel!
Don't a mackerel!
Hey, all right. Call back to you, man. Hey.
They gave me the warning beforehand.
No, sorry. No. It's from fucking...
Hey, watch that. Watch yourself.
Then I'm Shuffle T.
I know you gave
then
me the warning,
yeah,
but...
It's a little fishy.
Bunch of gangsters up here.
Now look! All right, this is important. This bit's important. I'm comfortable with my sexuality. All right? I mean, what? Is it gay to duct tape another man in a fantasy where you role play a butt rape? I mean, honestly... Is it gay to say I'd fuck stay?
Probably.
And I guess I've got a Facebook page to update. Titan of a penis.
Mm.
Kind of like a demon.
Mm.
Let's not lie about this either. I'd be the receiver.
This motherfucker here would have me crying out to Jesus, face down on the ground, having all kinds of violent seizures. Fuck you know about writing raps with no gay shit?
What?
I want this mighty man to go naked.
Scoot.
You're like a statue so bracing.
Gay.
Call him Michelangelo's David. And don't be fooled because of his race, because that monster cock is huge. It's visible from space, so that's common knowledge too. I recently got raped by a rotten prostitute, went home with tears all on my face because it wasn't you. Rod, we'll go to the water park. I'll run up to the top of the slide. If there's not the longest queue, then I'll be waiting for you, open arm to the bottom of the flume. And look, it'll be our fault if this battle hasn't got a lot of views. But it will, because you two are in it, and you two are winning. And a thumbnail on the YouTube clip using an image of you two will get more YouTubers clicking than those musical mixes using the trick of Googling pictures of beautiful women in a whack-ass attempt to be boosting their hits with. Such an equally measured teaming together, neither is second best. Shaving these other fruits down to size, that's lemon zest.
God's perfume is what they're fucking like, that's heaven sent. They've got a heart of gold, that's what I call a treasure chest.
Pat gets a discount in every store of 110%. And Roan would still look more manly than me right now, wearing a fucking wedding dress.
They need to reach their peak so they can be their very best in that mountainous summit to climb so they won't ever rest. And if you're pissed because you're thinking this battle is gay enough, just know that we never gave a fuck.
No. We never gave a...
Making love. Time.
That's fucking time.
Go.
Round three, it's on Pat and Roan. Let's get it.
Sorry, I don't know what that was all about. It's kind of cute, though. It was funny. Fuck the shit out of you.
You're like a fucking wildflower, man. It's beautiful. I could stare at you for 5 hours, fam. How cute are you? You see that shit? Pat Stay just fucking boop-ed you. I wish there was a million of you. I'm kind of pissed that there's only two of you. Fucking, I got a puppy last week. Cute little fact. Yeah, a fucking puppy. Cute little fact, I took him to a farm. He nuzzled chicklets that were soon to be hatched. He sat in baskets. It was fantastic. They were beautifully thatched. There were pumpkins there. I teared up as he moved through the patch. He had never seen a butterfly before. He chased one right through to my lap, and I swear, you motherfuckers are even cuter than that.
That? No? Okay. No word of this bullshit. You two are so talented that you make me self-conscious of my own skill. Rewriting all my verses, afraid that they won't kill. And I'm feeling like roadkill, and you're sitting there so chill. But I know if I don't pick myself up, then the two of you both will! Pat!
Oh, my bad. It's my turn, right?
Yeah.
I was just on my phone canceling the return flight.
You're staying here forever.
Love at first sight, you fuck my girl right. I like a man with hairs like yours, muscle shirt tight and a muddy dirt bike. Man in my dreams, tears in his Wrangler jeans. Hard worker, little country boy, Brad Pitt and Troy. Little fuck toy, bundle of joy, scrumptious little dumpling.
Okay, all right. He means well.
Fuck the shit out of him.
He's trying to be nice.
Straight up.
But do you even realize what you're doing? Of course you're beasts within rap, but pushing a lifestyle of compliments? It's deeper than that. See, with anonymous comments, the internet's a pretty scary place where we obscure our face but deign to compare our race. Little words bubble up, the product of buried hate from strangers. But strangely, every thought still carries weight, and it would be much easier to act like we didn't care. But we get caught up as it spirals in the air and it cycles to a cyclone, leaving lives in disrepair, thus sending all humanity down a spiral of despair. But then you come along. All positive, jocular, and completely change the game.
start making compliments popular. It's like you solve the calamity. We all become family. It's like by changing negative and positive, you charged up humanity. And when you think like that, it has more of a broad reach. When you think like that, shit gets more deep. You're pushing support speech, a world that doesn't endorse creeps, breaking hard exteriors and showing the world sweet. And fucking, we've got floor seats to where Earth and this force meet. Because when you think like that, it puts arms out of arm's reach. There'd be no more beef. We'd see all the war ceasing by you just being you. You would bring about world peace. Think about it. Think about it. Think about it.
Hey. You want to fuck my sister? She's yours. You deserve it, bro. She's fertile, so you can come inside her. I'll hide her birth control. She's a 13-year-old virgin, so just work it slow. I know what you're packing. I was next to you in the urinal. The biggest 16 inches fucking delicious sea biscuit horse fucking cock.
Okay, Jesus fucking Christ.
Forget it.
If we were going to rank the teams on this stage, we're probably second. The way you guys spit it so well, I think I got an erection. It's fucking pretty awesome that we even get to talk to these legends. So just to show our gratitude, we got you some presents.
Oh my God.
A bunch of fucking presents. Here we go. Enjoy it.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy all
Thank
that.
You Thank so you so much.
From us.
Christmas early.
We're gonna make some noise one time real quick. Let's go.
Round three, it's our Marlowe and Shuffle. Let's go.
Man. You got me flushing, my cheeks are rosy red. Motherfuckers bought me some sewing threads, come on. Shit. Hey. Wait. Hey.
That was the game we played, and you damn well know it.
I know from the stains.
Sticky as fuck,
too. Exact one.
Hey.
How gay is this, buddy?
When Rome walks into the club, the bouncer gives him a girl. Dude literally wins at any task with a signature swirl. He walked up to a piano like, think I'll give this a whirl. Oh, what do you know? I'm the best at this in the world. Internet sensation. He went viral on Facebook. Fucking mad likes. You all see that Big T intervention? Every punch was such a black eye because Roan's stuff was facts. Christ, it's called hard-hitting poet deconstructs a fat guy. None of that's right. They should have called it handsome young man saves another man's life. Because you see, what most don't know is that in the next 7 to 9 weeks, Big T lost 75 kilos with the help of some chai tea and a medical IV. He no longer feels self-conscious in incredibly tight jeans. He started up yoga and lessons in Tai Chi. He's skinnier than Marlon now. He's getting defined cheeks and re-entered the battling world as regular-sized T. I mean, of course, you're next to the throne. No one is as sexy as Ro. Looking like Ashton Kutcher in that 70s show. He'll run for office one day. President Rowan, you are getting my vote. Shit, I'll get citizenship and an American home. I'll be there for you, Rowan, if you're ever alone or can't cover your ass like a medical row. But there's no chance of that, because he's always ready to go. List of accomplishments longer than an elephant's nose. And he's incredibly toned from his head to his toes, from his flesh to his bones, because he's exercised more times than Emily Rose, Kevin Levrone, or Sylvester Stallone. You can't stop this guy when he gets in the zone. If you're his enemy, then it's the end of the road. He's the last white great American hope. Blood Diamond. Diamond in the rough. Like Sierra Leone! And did I mention he's toned?
Yes, you did, bro. You shared that shit earlier about Emily Rose.
Oh, yeah, of course. Sorry, I'm forgetful, you know.
It's okay, I understand. I mean, the presence of Roan sometimes makes my memory go and I can't remember my flow, which, of course, is... Where the fuck am I?
Does anyone know? You'll probably overthrow the Emperor of Rome.
Be that one guy to actually have sex with the Pope.
Saying you got it good, but I'm betting you don't.
Sliced bread is the motherfucking best thing since Rome!
Woo! Hey. And now that we're done with you... Now that we're done with you, Patrick, just know, I am your disciple. Any of you guys read his autobiography? It's called The Bible. I mean, Pat, what more is there to say? I mean, you're dope.
No. You're goat.
No. You're hope.
Pat tried to lose a battle once and accidentally won.
4-0.
Do you even realize how highly these people speak of you? Do you even know the nickname they keep for you? Jesus 2. But even the atheists believe in you.
Second.
But even the atheists believe in you.
He knows shape-shifting, space-twisting, telekinesis too.
The leader, the teacher, the chief, the dude.
He could turn an ever yarn into a sweet vermouth.
Dinosaurs were extinct because they didn't agree with you.
You walked down the... Hey! Hey! This is real shit. This is real shit. This is facts. You walk down the street and people scream for you like the 60s fans of the Beatles do.
You got homeless guys trying to feed you food.
Toddlers jumping out their prams trying to clean your shoes.
If Magic Valley's packed, then people move so you beat the queues.
You roll up at 2 a.m. when the park is closed and the manager runs down in his bathroom robe, doesn't care he's double parked and the car's been towed, just passes over the keys to you.
When you go to see your hometown play hockey, does it not happen? When you go to your hometown to play hockey, the referee, upon seeing you, calls over the managers to agree a truce and orders the visiting team to lose.
The mafia takes the heat for you.
God has wet dreams of you.
Pregnant women on the bus give up their motherfucking seats for you.
Intersection traffic parts like the Red Sea for you without even needing to, because the light already went green for you.
All the ladies to ever sleep with you say they enjoyed the stay like a retreat review.
Because it's a real treat with you.
See, Pat, it's time that you finally see the truth. You're the fucking moonwalking definition of extremely smooth.
Every piece of you.
Every gene of you.
Every fiber of your being is just screaming smooth.
There is literally no more perfecting that you need to do.
Immaculately conceived from the seed of Zeus.
You are a profound stepping stone towards completing human evolution. We mean it, dude.
I really mean it, dude.
Yeah. He does too.
I mean it too.
He means it too. Okay, we're not done.
We got more.
Oh. Okay, bit more.
Which means there's literally no wrong that he could do.
You could drop an N-bomb in an Obama press conference and he'd fist bump you in the meeting room.
You could... They could feature you on a Bieber tune and it wouldn't even cheapen you.
You could be a piece of poo.
A piece of poo.
And we'd all still believe in you. In fact, you know what? That's the thing about both these guys. They got something we all like.
So till we're 104 and done with the sport, you'll have our love and support, guys.
And after this battle, let's share a couple of cause lights.
What we're trying to say is,
these buckos are all right.
Hey, let's get a selfie. Time. We get a selfie. Yo, yo, get a selfie. So, pressure. Fuck yeah. Oh, yeah. Get in again. Selfie.
Hey, is the mic still on?
Make some
noise for that real quick!
Thanks so much!
Hey!
Oh shit, go!
Hey! Y'all hear me?
Hey, you better come
out. Hey! Fuck. You guys have a good time tonight or what? Yeah! Hey! Straight, I told all y'all guys, these motherfuckers are crazy. They're the reason why we did the first one in the first place. So give it up for Marlo and Shuffle Team from the UK.
Yeah!
Fuck yeah!
And Corbin's a little coward. Little bitch.
Again, y'all make some noise for Past Day Road, Marlo and Shuffle.
Thanks so much.
Shouts to Hopscotch, hey, appreciate y'all coming out. King of the Dab will be back 2016. You dig? Bro,
I want these for my coach.
Oh
my
Get God. The fuck out of here!
I'm good. I'm good.
Yeah. Haha. Hopscotch 2015. Nova Scotia makes some noise for that compliment battle! Woo!